In this video, we're going to talk about how to translate between statements about percent and equations. Let me start by writing down a few statements that are true about percentages. Okay, so all these statements are true. 8 is 50% of 16, 10% of 50 is 5, and 3 out of 50 is 6%. Those are all true statements, but what we want to do is we want to learn how to convert these statements into equations. When you're doing this, there are a couple of main words to look out for. The word of is typically going to translate into multiplication. The word is going to translate into an equal sign. And the phrase out of is going to refer to division. So let's go through using these three main guidelines, and let's write each one of these three statements as a mathematical equation. Let's start with this. 8 is, we learned that is going to translate into an equal sign. Now 50%. Typically what I'll do with percentages is I'll write them as decimals when we're writing them in equation form. You learned how to do that in the last video. Of is going to translate into multiplication, and 16. So what we just wrote is that 8 is 0.5 times 16, which is true. So we just converted a true statement about percentages into a true equation about percentages. Let's do the same thing over here. 10% is 0.10, of translates into multiplication, 50 is translates into equals, and a 5. So we just wrote that 0.1 times 50 equals 5, which is also true. And this last one, 3 out of 50, that's going to be 3 out of is division, so there's 3 out of 50. Is an equal sign. 6%. 6%, if we move the decimal place twice, is written as 0.06. And that's a true statement as well. 3 divided by 50 is 0.06. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a statement that has an unknown in it, write that statement as an equation, and then solve that equation for the unknown. Let me show you what I mean. Let's take a look at this statement. 96% of what number is 72. Now I copied down the list of words that we can translate into math. We need to add to this list because we now have what number in this sentence. Now anytime we see what or what number or something like that in one of our statements about percentages, we're going to turn that into an unknown, which I typically like to just call x. So let's do it with this sentence. 96%, we're going to write that as a decimal, 0.96, of is multiplication, what number is going to be an x, is going to be an equal sign, 72. So now we've taken this question and we've converted it into an equation that we can solve. Typically what we would do is we'd write this as 0.96x equals 72. And then the goal of this equation is to solve for x, which you learned previously in this class. You can solve for x by dividing both sides of the equation by the number in front of x, which in this case is 0.96. That cancels. The 0.96 is canceled on the left side, and you're just left with x equals 72 divided by 0.96. To do this problem, you just work out the long division. You can check my work over here. I got that x is 75. Let's make sure that makes sense. 96% of 75 is 72. I think that does make sense. So I'm going to box it up and call that an answer. Let's try one more. 7 is 4% of what number? We translate that into an equation. 7 is equals 4%. If we move the decimal place twice, it's going to be 0.04 of, and then what number is x? So again, we have an equation that we can solve. Typically, we would write it as 7 equals 0.04x. And we know how to solve this equation. Same as last time. We divide by the number that's in front of the x, which is 0.04. And we get that x equals 7 divided by 0.04, and we just have to do the long division again. I worked out the long division over here, and I got that x is 175. Let's again make sure that that answer makes sense. 7 is 4% of 175. I think that does make sense, so we'll call that problem finished. Okay, that's it for this video. Let's get you a quiz. First problem, 41 is 20% of what number? Next problem, 8 is what percent of 20? Write each of these statements as an equation and solve the equation to answer the question. The second problem is just slightly different than the ones that we did in this video, but give it a shot. See what you can learn. Okay, good luck, and I'll see you in the next video.